Today, we would like to welcome Dr. Jon Story, an expert in diet and cardiovascular health. He's going to talk to us a little bit about the basics of fats in our diet and how the new high oleic soybean oil matches up. Welcome. To get us started, can you just tell us a little bit about the fats in our diet?
Well, the fat in our diet is an important component of our diet, especially for energy. It's the most rich source of energy in our diet, and it's the good news and the bad news. If you need energy, fat's a good way to get it, but when you have too much, it's a good way to get too much. Fats are we should probably define the words fats and oils. Fats tend to are supposed to be solid at room temperature. So lard and butter and things like that should be called fats. And oils are liquid at room temperature, like soybean oil or corn oil or whatever. Those fats are made up of triglycerides that are a glycerol molecule with three fatty acids on them. The fatty acids are just long chains of carbon with some double bonds inserted in some of them. So that's where we get saturated fatty acids, where there are no double bonds, and the unsaturated, usually we talk about monounsaturated and polyunsaturated, that have either one mono or more than one polyunsaturated fatty acid or double bonds inserted. And that gives fats their characteristics. The unsaturated fats tend to be in oils where they're liquid at room temperature. The saturated fats have a difference in melting point, so they're solid at room temperature a lot of times. And the fats that we eat are usually mixtures of these fatty acids. They aren't all one or the other. So that's why a lot of times there's a misconception, well, I'm eating corn oil, so it's polyunsaturated. Well, there's a mixture of saturated and polyunsaturated. The same's true for soybean and lard and butter, and all of them have a mixture. But they're predominantly one or the other.
So if people have a health concern, which types of fats should they choose in their diet?
Well, I think that we probably are tending toward thinking that, as with everything in the diet, it's best to eat a variety of things. But with fat, it's probably tending toward the mono and polyunsaturated fatty acids, especially the monounsaturated fatty acids. The research seems to show give an advantage, and fats and oils that have more monounsaturated fatty acids are easily used in our diets, so that part isn't a problem.
So what about for those of us that may not have any health concerns?
Well, it's still, again, if you don't have any of these health problems, it really is important to eat a variety of foods and balance them, and energy balance would then be the concern, is the amount of fat. But again, it's probably tending toward polyunsaturated fat, so you don't increase your risk for heart disease.
Sure, sure. So with this new high oleic soybean oil, where do we find it and how does that all fit in?
Well, the high oleic soybean oil typically has some oleic, but not very much. And this high oleic has been modified so that it has higher levels of oleic acid. Oleic is a monounsaturated fatty acid that we've been talking about. And so it gives it an advantage to provide more monounsaturated fatty acids in an oil that is commonly used in a lot of salad dressings and other things that this could be substituted for and increase the oleic consumption.
So when we think about the different kinds of foods that, you know, may contain a high oleic soybean oil, how does that fit into our diet, or does it have a place in our diet?
It can easily. I've heard that one of the places it's been used quite a bit already is with fried foods, with deep fat frying, that it's been used quite a lot. I'm not recommending we all go out there and live on French fries, but that's one use. But it can substitute, salad dressings and things like that that have oil in. And then a lot of baked goods and things you at home, while you use oil as a source of fat. And it can substitute, I think, pretty much for any of the other fats that you would typically, or oils that you would typically use.
So we know that there are some foods that cause allergic reaction. And so some people are allergic to soybeans. Is that a concern or a risk that we should think about when we think about this new high oleic soybean oil?
No, and because the protein is what causes, allergic reactions most of the time. And they're obviously, I shouldn't say obviously maybe, but then fats and oils, there's not protein of any consequence. And the modification that's been done to increase the oleic acid, also the way that that's done now eliminates that possibility pretty much completely for these modified foods.
Okay, so can you tell us how we might identify a high oleic soybean oil?
Well, you can't pick it out of a lineup. You're gonna have to read the food label. As they start appearing, I'm guessing that they'll probably be advertised on the front of the box as contains high oleic soybean oil or contains more oleic acid. But to be sure, you can read the contents, ingredients label on, or ingredients list on the label to see whether it's listed there. Because it'll list oils, fats and oils, and if it says soybean oil, it'll probably have to say high oleic.
Great, great. So consumers will be able to identify this product.
Yeah,
great. Well, thank you so much for providing us the basic information about diet and how the high oleic soybean oil fits into that.
Great, it's been a pleasure.